In this tutorial, you'll learn how to make this transition using optics compensation and a handful of other effects. By hand creating transitions, you'll have the ability to make tweaks and give them a customized look. You'll learn how to save these transitions as animation presets and bring them into any project with just a few clicks, so all of your hard work won't go to waste. Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This transition tutorial will help you develop skills using adjustment layers, saving and using animation presets, and using a combination of effects that you may not have even known were possible. You'll learn skills and techniques that you can use every day at your job, for your clients, and in your own personal projects. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at Envato Elements. Check them out using the link in the description below and get an amazing 70% off your first month, as well as unlimited downloads with your membership. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Once you sign up, you won't remember how you ever designed or animated before Envato Elements. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a Shape Layer Rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, the 70% discount for Envato Elements, and the project file and presets for this episode can all be found in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. In the previous tutorial, we created a transition using a number of effects, and we saved it as an animation preset. I showed you how you can bring it into any project by accessing it from your effects and presets panel. In this tutorial, we'll be making another transition to add to our library. Again, we'll be using optics compensation along with a handful of other effects. Okay, so I have these two video clips here. I downloaded these from my sponsor site, Envato Elements, but you can use any video clips you'd like. So this is gonna be a 30 frame animation. So let's right click in the area that's to the left of our timeline, new adjustment layer. So Option Alt click the left bracket to bring your endpoint over to where your playhead is. Shift page down, 1, 2, 3. Then Option or Alt click your right bracket to bring your out point to where your playhead is. And we want this to be 10 frames to the midpoint and then 20 frames to the out point. I'll be putting my playhead at the 2-second mark where these two clips meet, and I'm going to add in all of our effects that we'll need for this one. So we'll go to Effect, Stylize, Motion Tile, Effect, Stylize, and let's add in a glow. Go to Effect, Distort, Transform, and then Effect, Distort, Optics Compensation. Close up all of these effects and we'll go through these one at a time. I'm going to set my motion tile output width to 150, output height to 150, and mirror edges because the edges of our frame will be affected. Let's close that up. Let's go into our glow here and we want to set our glow threshold down to 0. And then we want our intensity to set that to 0.2. So just a slight glow here is all we're looking for. Okay, now we need to put a keyframe for this intensity because that's the value that we'll be animating. And close that up, down to transform. We're going to put a keyframe for scale, change that to 250. I'm going to go ahead and hit U now to bring up my keyframes because for this effect to work, I want both clips to scale up. So where we have this keyframe for scale at 250, just go down one frame and then we want to change this value for scale to 50. So it's going to make the next one really small. And as you can see, our video now is smaller than our frame. So we're going to be making adjustments to our optics compensation to take care of that. But you can see how the motion tile is going to be affecting this outer part of our frame here. Okay, and then let's make sure you're back at this 2-second mark. We're going to close up transform and then open up optics compensation. And we want to set this field of view to 150. Make sure we have a keyframe for that. Choose this reverse lens distortion. So see, now if we go down to that one frame where it's set to 50, we can see that the edges are filled out. So now let's hit U to bring up all of our keyframes here. So if you click I, it goes to the beginning of this layer here. And we just want to set our glow intensity to 0, our scale for transform to 100, field of view down to 0. So this is the original clip that we have. As you can see, there's no change. And as we start to go in, we can see how the transition is going to work. So now press O to go to the out point of this layer. And we just want to grab these keyframes, copy paste, And then we want to highlight all of our keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. And let's grab this first set of keyframes, go to our graph editor, pull those all the way to the right. Go to this last set of keyframes here, highlight those, graph editor, pull all those to the left. I'm going to loop this, so go right before transition, hit B, go a little bit after it, hit N, and then watch it play back. And so we have a transition that looks kind of like that, which is kind of cool, I think. Now, you can do a number of things with this. You can add in more of a glow if you'd like. So see, this just kind of increases our glow a little bit. Maybe you want to increase that glow intensity a bit. So maybe you say 0.5, and it just has a little bit more of a glow that kind of pops in there. So the cool thing about this is that you can customize this and do anything you like with it. You can add in a blur, whatever you would like. So this transition is completely customizable. We're going to save this as an animation preset. So let's close up all of this, highlight effects here, animation, save animation preset. If you save your presets in one setting, After Effects will bring you back to the last place you saved an animation preset. I saved my last preset to this 7-minute AE folder, but just to recap, you need to make sure you're in Documents, Adobe, the version you're using, User Presets, and then either create your preset there or create folders like I have here. I'm just going to call this Optics Compensation Zoom. Click Save. Let's go to the beginning of our adjustment layer here. Right click, Effect, Remove All to get rid of all of our effects. Go to our Effects and Presets panel, Animation Presets, User Presets, 7-minute, Optics Comp Zoom. Now, this has a lot of keyframes, so one of the things that's important whenever you're adding in a preset to a layer is it's going to drop the first keyframe wherever your playhead is located. So make sure you have your playhead at the beginning of this layer. Double click and we see all of our keyframes come in. We watch it play back. This is exactly what we saved. So over the past two tutorials, we've created two transitions using optics compensation along with a few other effects. And now we are on our way to creating a library full of cool transitions that can be brought into any project with just the click of a button. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds and virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, the amazing 70% discount for Envato Elements, and the project file and presets for this episode can all be found in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.